Classics SOF NSO Level 2. Science question number 1. The given graph represents the motion of a moving object. Select the correct statement regarding it. First one, the object is not stationary at time 3. This is true. Second one, the object is moving with uniform velocity. Yes, it is moving with uniform velocity. The object is not at starting point at time t by 2. Since we don't know if the exact starting point of the object is t by 2, we will not consider this statement true or false. Fourth one, the area of P and Q region of the graph are same. Yes, this is true. Science question number 2. Avin tied a small stone to one end of the string that he had. Then he held the other end of the string and started whirling it. Initially slowly, then faster and faster. Which of the following statement is RR incorrect? The stone always undergoes circular motion. Yes, this is true, because Avin is circling it in a circle. The distance of the stone from Avin's hand keeps changing. This is false, because the distance from the stone to Avin's hand does not change. The stone undergoes non-periodic motion. Yes, because he started slowly, then faster and faster. Science question 3. A person of height 3.2 meter stands on ground 1 meter in front of a vertical plane mirror. The bottom edge of the mirror is on the ground. Then select the correct statements regarding it. The mirror only needs to be half the height of the person because the distance from the person's eye to the mirror and from the mirror to the feet or head is the same. The light rays reflecting from the mirror to the eyes need to cover only half of the total distance. So, for a person who is 3.2 meters tall, the minimum length of the mirror required would be half their height. Minimum mirror length required is equal to 3.2 by 2, that is 1.6 meters. So, using this information, we can see that only the second option is the correct one. Science question number 4. Geeta set up an experiment as shown below to find out how much light can pass through different materials. She placed 4 materials, K, L, M, and N, one at a time at the position X. Geeta then records intensity of light detected by the light sensor as shown in the given table. Which one of the given materials she uses if she wants to make curtains for her bedroom to not let the sunlight enter? Since in a bedroom, we don't want light to enter, we need the lesser intensity material, that is the M material. Science question number 5. Suresh stands at point P as shown in the given figure. Which of the pins 1, 2, 3, 4 will Suresh be able to see in the mirror? The number 1 is positioned exactly along the normal line. Then, rays coming from the number will either go directly into the mirror or along the normal. In this case, there is no reflected ray at an angle that can reach the observer's eye. The light would be either absorbed or reflected straight back along the normal. And no observable image would form. So, he cannot see the pin 1, but he can see pin 2, 3 and 4. Science question 6. A student finds a slab of an unknown substance. To observe the nature of the slab, she conducts an experiment and finds out the following outcomes. According to the observation, we can say that soft iron is the material. Soft iron is considered a temporary magnetic material, and this property is a result of its ability to become magnetized in the presence of a magnetic field, but it loses its magnetism quickly once the external magnetic field is removed. So, the answer is soft iron. Science question 7. The given figure shows a pole fixed in the center of a garden. 4 students observe the shadow formed by the pole at different time intervals and then plotted the graph of height of shadow in centimeter versus their observation time as shown. Which of the given graphs show correct observation? The length of the shadow is influenced by the angle of the sun in the sky. The lower the sun, the longer the shadow. In the morning, when the sun is rising, shadows are long because the sun's rays are at a low angle. At noon, when the sun is at its highest, the shadows are shortest. In the afternoon, as the sun sets, shadows grow longer again. So, according to this observation, figure 4 is the correct one. Science question 8. Three identical lamps, L1, L2 and L3 are connected as shown in the given circuit. Which combination of switches make the lamp L1 glow brightest among the three lamps? In a series circuit, the current flows through all components, in this case, lamps one after the other. The brightness of a lamp depends on the current flowing through it. If only one lamp is glowing, all the current will pass through it and it will have maximum brightness. If there are other lamps in the circuit, the current is divided and the brightness of each lamp would decrease. So, when switch S1 is closed and S2 is open, the maximum brightness will be in L1 because L1 is the only lamp glowing and they are connected in the series. Science question 9. Two iron pins are placed at the ends of a bar magnet of length 4 meter as shown in the given figure. If another bar magnet of 1 meter length is used in place of the given one, which of the following diagrams will represent the correct situation? As we know, when iron pins are near a magnet, they become magnetized and also act as a magnet. When two iron pins are attracted to either end of the magnet, the ends of the pins also become magnetic, attract each other. When the pins are magnetized at each end by the magnet, the opposite poles of the magnet on the iron pins attract each other, causing them to stick together. So the answer is the B option. Science question 10. A person spreads some iron fillings uniformly on a sheet of paper. Then she places the given magnet on the sheet. Which of the following correctly represent the number of iron fillings stick to various parts of the magnet? The magnetic field is stronger at the poles of the magnet, both the north and south poles, and weakest at the center or middle of the magnet. This is because the magnetic field lines are more concentrated at the poles, leading to stronger magnetic force, whereas at the center, the magnetic field is less intense. So, according to this information, the A option is the correct graph. Science question number 11. A circuit consists of battery E, a resistor R, and two light bulbs X and Y, connected as shown in the given figure. If the filament of the light bulb X burns out, then select the correct statement about the light bulb Y. In a series circuit, the current flows through all components, in this case, lamps, one after the other. The brightness of a lamp depends on the current flowing through it. If only one lamp X is not glowing, all the current will pass through Y and it will have maximum brightness. According to this information, the C option is the correct option. Science question number 12. Which of the following statements are incorrect? First one, electric cell is a three-terminal device with positive, negative and neutral terminal. Wrong. An electric cell is a two-terminal device with positive terminal, cathode and a negative terminal, anode. Second one, in electric cell, heat energy is converted into electric energy. Wrong. An electric cell produces electric energy through chemical reactions. Third one, the chemicals stored in electric cell are exhaustible in nature. Exhaustible means that chemicals inside an electric cell can be used up over time as the cell operates. As the cell discharges, the chemical reaction inside it converts the stored chemical energy into electrical energy. So this statement is true. An electric cell resting on a table vertically represents a closed circuit. Wrong. An electric cell resting on a table vertically does not represent a closed circuit. Science question number 13. The distance time graph of two persons X and Y in a 100 meter race are depicted in the given figure. Then select the incorrect statements. First one, X and Y are at maximum distance to each other at the time duration 8 to 10. The maximum distance to each other is in the time duration 4 to 8, not 8 to 10. So this is false. Second one, the maximum distance between x and y is more than 20 meters. From the graph, we can see that curves x and y diverge greatly, with the gap largest around the middle of the time interval. So we can conclude the maximum distance between x and y is more than 20 meters. Third one, the average speed of x is greater than that of y. From the graph, we can see that y travels along long distance in same time as x. So we can conclude that average speed of y is greater than x. So this is wrong. Science question number 14. Read the given table carefully. Based on the information, what could be the substance P and Q? P could be coin and Q could be wooden block. Science question number 15. Class 6 students were provided with the following mixtures. Students were asked to suggest various methods for the separation of components of these mixtures. Out of the given options, select the correct one. The correct one is that Ankit suggested evaporation for mixture 1 and Advik suggested filtration for mixture 4. Science question number 16. In the given Venn diagram, P, Q, R and S represent 4 different substances. Select the correct option. Regarding the substances P, Q, R and S, since Q is in the middle, it has to satisfy all the 3 properties. So we are going to take Q. In the A and D option, there is Q. Q could either be a ceramic cup or a rubber band. One of the properties of Q is soft. Ceramic cup can't be the answer because ceramic cup is hard, not soft. So we can take the D option. Yes, Q is soft, non-lustrous and floats on water, which are all properties of a rubber band. Similarly, R can be a pencil. Yes, this is true. Pencil is non-lustrous and floats on water. So the answer is D. Science question number 17. Match the column 1 with column 2 and select the correct option for the given codes. Chalk powder plus water can go with filtration. Rice plus toad is hand picking. Wheaten husk is winnowing. Wheaten stalks is threshing. Science question number 18. Read the following statement carefully and select the correct option. For separating a mixture of sand, salt and naphthalene, sublimation would be the first step to separate one of the components. Naphthalene is a substance that undergoes sublimation, meaning it changes directly from solid to gas without passing through the liquid phase when heated. Heat the mixture, naphthalene will sublimate and turn into a gas, leaving behind the salt and sand. Add the water to the mixture, as salt is soluble in water while sand is not. Stir the mixture to dissolve the salt. Filter the mixture to separate the sand from the salt water solution. Finally, evaporate the water from the salt solution to recover the salt. Second one, mixture containing salt and sand can be separated by sieving. No, this is wrong. So the answer will be statement 1 is true, but statement 2 is false. Science question number 19. 3 students of class 6 suggest the methods to separate the given types of mixtures. The method given by which of them is correct? Anushka said that a heterogeneous solid liquid mixture can be separated by filtration. Yes, this is true. Jay said that a heterogeneous solid-solid mixture can be separated by sedimentation and decantation. No, this is false, because sedimentation and decantation is there in solid-liquid mixture, not a solid-solid mixture. Kirti said that a heterogeneous liquid-liquid mixture can be separated by crystallization. Crystallization is not there in liquid-liquid mixtures. It is used to separate solid-liquid mixtures. So, Kirti is wrong. Only Anushka is correct. Science question number 20. What happens when a mixture of sand and camphor powder is heated? The camphor powder in the mixture sublimes into a gas when heated. The sand remains as it is because it does not undergo sublimation. The camphor vapor can be collected by cooling it in a funnel, leaving the sand behind. So, B option is correct. Sand is left in the china dish. Science question number 21. The three different types of material 1, 2 and 3 are shown in the given figure through which an alphabet P can be seen as follows. From the given information A, B, C, we can make a tabular column. One is either glass or clear plastic curtain since it's transparent. Two can be brick wall, iron door or wooden door since it's opaque. Three is frosted glass as it is translucent. Using this, we can check which option is correct. The C option is correct. Science question number 22. Three students of class 6 made a list of objects based on some common properties. Each student put a wrong object in his or her list. Select the wrong object placed by the student. In student 1, honey is the wrong object because it's translucent, while others are transparent. Student 2, wooden spoon floats in water, while others sink in water. Student 3, salt, sugar, oil, vinegar. Oil is not miscible in water, while the others are miscible in water. Science question number 23. Only 25 grams of a substance T can be dissolved in 100 ml of water at 25 degrees Celsius. Each 4 students were provided with 50 grams each of substance T and 200 ml of water and asked to make a saturated solution at 25 degrees Celsius. Students mixed the given components in the following proportions. Which of the following statements is correct? Given 25 grams of a substance T can be dissolved in 100 ml. Student 1 dissolves 50 grams in 200 ml water. And student 2 dissolves 25 grams in 100 ml water. So the C option, only student 1 and 2 made a saturated solution. Science question number 24. The property of a material to sink or float in a water depends upon the comparable densities of carrier substances. The densities of various substances are given in the following table. Select the correct statement from the following. An object will float if its density is less than the density of liquid. An object will sink if the density is greater than the density of liquid. Using this, we can say that both aluminium and silver will float on mercury. Science question number 25. Select the incorrect statement about mixture from the following. All the mixtures are soluble in water. This is false. Though water is called a universal solvent, all the mixtures are not dissolvable in water. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. Hit that like button and turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.